Here's the formula for advertising. Okay, first remember we said when we have a target market, we want to use publicity first on them for third-party trust and awareness. Then we use advertising, and from advertising we go to educational sales. So in advertising, I'm going to send you some material on name recognition advertising versus direct response advertising. You have to be aware of the difference and which model we use and why. So we're going to be covering that. But the basics of advertising. Now remember, advertising is sent to people who have a perceived need or we're trying to grab their attention. So advertising, the formula for that is problem. You identify the problem because people are motivated by solving problems. They're not motivated, in other words, motivated meaning willing to spend time or money. They're not very motivated by pleasure factors. Remember, there's five reasons why we're motivated: avoiding present pain, avoiding future pain, present pleasure, future pleasure, and curiosity. Out of all five of those factors, 80% of where we will spend our time or money is to avoid present pain. And present pain is defined as Maslow's hierarchy of needs, the first level of Maslow's need, which is to get out of survival, and security. Those are the two primary factors that we will spend our time and money getting out of. Those are pain-based motivating factors. So do you think we want to do, you think our communication, we want to do pleasure sales or present pain marketing?
Present pain.
Yeah, that's where it's at. That, because that's where the human is motivated. So we're going to look at, we're going to be dealing with the present pain of the attorney. And remember, the need for the attorney, there's three factors. There's three needs for a personal injury attorney. One is to avoid present pain. Well, present pain to an attorney is loss of money. That's the present. That's the number one motivation for the attorney, is the amount of money they're losing, not the amount of money they can make. That's the second need. Are you going to, Andy, will you pay more attention to $200,000 you're losing or $200,000 that you could potentially make?
Probably more attention to what we can make.
So you wouldn't care about the $200,000 you're losing right now?
Yeah, I would.
If you had a choice between one or the other, which one, where would you pay all your attention if I said, Andy, here's $200,000 you can make and here's $200,000 you're losing right now? Where's all your attention going?
Well, that you're losing right now, yeah.
You get my point? Mm-hmm. Now, Andy, I just told you something major. Because everybody thinks the attorney is motivated by more money. They are, but that is not the primary need. The primary need is the money they're losing. Here's the problem, though. Do they know they're losing it, Andy?
No, probably not.
They don't know they're losing it. So there's not a need. So if you have the ability to show them how much money they're losing, and you're the solution to stop them from losing money in their personal injury cases, guess who becomes the referral source?
I do.
That's right. That's exactly how it works. But you have to know it. You've got to know these things and how to present them and how to communicate. You have to be aware of motivating factors in your target audience and press the right emotional buttons. You got to know these things. So it's the three motivating factors for attorneys are the money they lose, making more money, and saving time. Those are the three motivating factors. Okay, those are the need-based factors. Now, after that, there's what's called primary service factors and secondary service factors. Those aren't motivating reasons to do something, but after there's the motivation to, you know, refer to a doctor or whatever, then those become important to make sure you have the primary service factors in place and the secondary service factors in place. But if there's no motivation, can you see how the primary and secondary service factors are totally irrelevant?
Right. Mm-hmm.
And guess where most people spend their time and energy when they're dealing with attorneys and trying to get referrals?
On the last two.
Yeah, typically they go into pleasure communication, right? Mm-hmm. Give them tickets to the ball game, basket of fruit, right?
Yep.
Is that pain motivated? Can he live without a basket of fruit?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. That's pathetic marketing is what that is. It's pathetic. And then the other thing they'll do is they'll go into service factors. Well, a service factor doesn't matter if there's not a perceived need. If that attorney doesn't realize that he's losing a lot of money if he doesn't use your services on that case. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So all I'm trying to do is share with you this picture, because how do you need to think? You need to start thinking like your target market, right?
Yeah.
You got to start understanding what motivates them. How do they think? And all your communication is based on how your target market thinks, not how, what you want to force upon them. So that's what we're going to be paying attention to with the personal injury attorney marketed segment. So that's where there's a huge potential, because the majority of personal injury attorneys don't use chiropractors, and the majority of personal injury patients don't see chiropractors. So when we use the combination of publicity, advertising, and educational sales through campaigns, we just we now have access to the right side of that market, don't we?
Yep.
By the way, Andy, that's how I was able to open 77 offices in 20 states. I didn't wait around for 8%. I didn't nickel and dime trying to get more of the 8% of patients versus the competition. I used what I just shared with you. I knew how to go into the 92% market because 3 out of 4 of those people had back pain, neck pain, or headaches. And I knew how to do educational sales. And I knew how to just pick them out in mass. Those people with back pain, neck pain, and headaches. And none of them were looking for chiropractors. And guess how much competition I had with my fellow chiropractors going after that market, Andy?
Very, very little.
Very little. Not many chiropractors even understand the basics of advertising to get the majority or a higher percentage of the 8%. So when we look at the formula for advertising, the formula is problem. Identify the problem, a primary pain-based problem, number one. Number two, solution. You have to be able to offer the solution to their problem. Number three, why you? Why you has to do with trust. It's endorsements and testimonials. It's social proof. So it's problem, solution, why you. And then we want to do an offer and a deadline, a relevant offer and a deadline to increase the motivation to get them to act. So that's the formula for advertising that we'll use. Make sense?
Yep.
Okay.